The first thing that it's important to notice about the supplied code is that in the array angles, the angles are measured in degrees. But as we said earlier, the cosine and sine functions in Python's math library take arguments that are measured in radians, not in degrees. So the first thing that we need to do is convert each of the angles in the array angles into radians. We do that by multiplying each angle by pi and dividing by 180. This gives us this new variable, angle in radians, or angle rad. The next step is to set the initial position and velocity of the particle. As you can see from these two lines, we've decided that the particle is going to begin at zero in both the horizontal and vertical planes. So this means that it's starting at the origin. Moving on to velocity, we set both the horizontal and the vertical velocity by taking the initial speed, which we set up here, and multiplying by the cosine of the angle, which we just converted, for the horizontal velocity, or the sine for the vertical velocity. Lastly, we finally make use of the forward Euler method. If we want to find out what the position after the next step is going to be, then we begin with the position at the step that we're at, and then add the time step times the velocity at that present step. You'll remember that this makes sense in terms of units because h is measured in time and v is measured in distance over time, which makes this term also measured in distance, just like x. We do something very similar with velocity, except that this time the acceleration is a constant, which we set up here as the gravitational constant. This means that the value of the acceleration is not going to change from step to step, although the value of the velocity will. Something else that you might want to note is that we've only set the range to go from 0 to numsteps minus 1. You might initially have thought that we should insert numsteps plus 1 as the argument of the range, but because we're looking at the step plus 1 row in both x and v, we need to restrict the range to be 1 less than we would have otherwise made it. In fact, I made this error myself when I was looking over the code, so it makes perfect sense if you were thinking that too. After all of this has been filled in, we can run the program and get this plot. Now this is a plot of the position, not of the velocity. You can see that the horizontal axis measures the horizontal position in meters. The vertical axis measures the vertical position in meters. Each different series here corresponds to each different element in the angles array, which you can see because each of these particles is leaving at a different initial angle. From this graph, we can see that as we change the initial angle, we also drastically change where the particle is going to end up landing. Now we'll move on to a problem that combines both this idea of ballistic trajectory and the idea of orbits from the previous problem.